Okay, so I got my box back. This weighs about 10 kilos, and I just paid 66 euros for taxes. Apparently, I got taxed for getting my stuff back, and these are not even new stuff that I got from Korea. These are just my old stuff that my parents sent from Korea, like, just some hair accessories, some clothes, some hangers, some shoes that I this has always been mine. Like, this is not new stuff, and a bunch of clothes, some gym clothes and stuff like that. And I had to pay 66 euros. Did I say that? Yes, I'm just shocked by the price. By the way, I had to go through another ordeal to get that cash, 6 euros. So you have to like pay them exactly 6 euros also on top of that. And if you don't have cash, they don't take cards or anything. So you need to prepare your cash money, basically. So I got this finally. It arrived like several days ago, actually, in France, but only today I was able to re receive it because I was, well, today I was at home. I prepared my cash finally. So yeah, if you don't pay me the money, then they're just going to take your package and they're not going to give it to you. So that's that. Well, yeah, and on the way back, I missed the stop. And so I went even further by tram, but no worries. I can easily walk back home along the Promenade des Anglais or just take the tram on the other side or the bus or whatever. So I guess that's why I wasn't paying attention all the time. Anyway, so on the way back, I found a very nice looking little viennoiserie and boulangerie. They sometimes do it together. I think, I'm not sure if, well, actually, I saw sandwiches and some baguettes, so I guess it's like a mix also. This place, it usually sells like dessert, sweet stuff. So basically, I got these things today. It's really nice, right? Pain au chocolat, we all know what that is. Classic French breakfast, I heard, but I don't usually eat sweet stuff for breakfast. But this is irresistible. I really love those. Even in Korea, I would always pick pain au chocolat. And this is called beignet, this donut-looking thing. And inside, there's like very, very sweet apple syrup and a lot of sugar all over. It's very delicious. It tastes like just really sweet donut, actually. And last but not least, I got this. I could not resist. I end up buying more than I should. Raisin, so like, dried grape, and just some nice snail looking, escargot looking bread. I'm sure. Well, we have these also in Korea, but we're in France, and I wanted to taste authentic French viennoiserie, these sweet stuff. And well, yeah, this is what I got. And so I just made a nice cup of coffee. I'll show you. So yeah, as you can see here, a nice cup of coffee with this is Mocha Bialetti that we got from Italy. With the nice little G on there. Yeah, it's really nice. It's 3 cup size, but I drink like 2 cups a day, so it's really the perfect size for me. And voila, this is the vanilla flavored coffee powder, coffee ground powder that I was talking about before. Tastes so nice, and the aroma is just amazing. Like, the entire home smells like sweet vanilla and coffee. And it's really not sweet. That's the interesting thing, is that it's not sweet at all. And it's just a normal, like, mocha espresso, but it's rich in vanilla flavor. And you can choose from a variety of flavors in Bialetti. I'm not advertising or anything. I literally bought all these on my own, like with my money. And so it has nothing to do with advertisement. I'm just saying that I really love this brand. And yeah, I really recommend it for people. I would say if you're Korean,
한국인이면 커피 믹스랑 맛이 굉장히 비슷한데, 그 대신 단맛이 아예 없는, 설탕이 아예 없어요. So has no sugary flavor. It's not sweet, but it has that Korean coffee mix, very appetizing, I would say, flavor. It's really good. It's a very pleasant type of sweetness. It's not one of those breads that are too sweet, that it becomes difficult to eat, really. Surprisingly, it's sweet, but it's not like that. So I think I can finish it with no problem. And I've been craving for sweet stuff lately. I'm totally looking forward to checking out other boulangeries and viennoiserie in France, because I mean that's one of the good things about living in France, I think, despite their slow administration, related services. Anyways, yep. So these sweet stuff, they make my worries go away.
Maintenant, on est à chez Pipo. Je l'ai vu dans le blog. C'était recommandé de Soka à Nice. It's like local food in Nice. Et j'ai pris Soka Biera. It's made with chickpeas, I guess, because Soka is made with chickpeas. Un pois de quoi? Ça s'appelle
Les
comment?
pois chiches.
Oui, les pois chiches en français. Donc, je vais goûter ça. C'est la première fois que je bois bière au pois chiche.
Ah oui.
C'est cool. Santé.
Allez, tiens.
Santé.
Santé.
Bon. Bah voilà, on va manger les tartignades, juste les pains avec les tartignades. Je crois que c'est le mien.
Ça, c'est olive noire.
Olive noire,
c'est olive
olive
vert.
vert. Et
Ça,
c'est quoi?
c'est poivron.
Poivron.
Et lui, c'est
légumes. On a oublié.
Provençal, provençal.
Provençal? Je sais pas ce que c'est. Et on met ça, le tartignade,
sur le pain.
Sur le pain, comme en confiture en fait, et on mange ensemble. Tu veux manger d'abord?
Bah non, on peut manger ensemble, oui.
Oui, mais vas-y.
Bah c'est quoi? C'est juste, oui. Tu prends le pain. Hop.
C'est du poivron.
Oui, c'est poivron.
Dis-moi le goût en fait.
Oui.
Ça a l'air un peu comme salsa sauce. La ah, couleur. Bien, hein.
Comme la sauce quoi?
Salsa. Salsa. Mexicain. Hein.
Ah bon? Non. C'est aussi.
Goûte-le déjà. Hein. C'est bon? Il a dit c'est bon. En fait, mon chéri, il parle pas, il peut pas parler quand il mange. L'odeur, j'aime bien l'odeur, c'est pas trop lourd. Et déjà, c'est pas très très lourd non plus. Comme tu vois, c'est très fin en fait.
Bah, c'est mieux parce que sinon c'est bourratif en fait.
Oui, oui. Ah, c'est chaud. C'est bon. La mienne, c'est avec du fromage parmigiano, je pense. C'était ça.
C'est avec parmigiano.
Et le tien, c'était quoi?
Le mien, c'est avec des poivrons.
Poivrons encore?
Bah oui, moi j'aime bien les poivrons.
C'est bon?
Oui, moi oui.
Tu t'attendais pas que le goût ça serait comme ça ou?
C'est un peu plus fin que ce que je pensais. En Italie, ils les font plus épaisses, c'est pour ça.
Ah ouais?
Je m'attendais à ce que ce soit plus épais.
C'est beaucoup plus délicieux que celui que je m'attendais, donc c'est bon, oui. Je pense qu'il faut essayer quand tu viens à Nice, chez Pipo. Ok, I'll try to explain what it tastes like. It doesn't taste like pizza, to be honest. No, it doesn't taste like pizza. It tastes more like ton that we have in Korea. To be exact, more dokdo ton. That one is also made with beans, so this is made with chickpeas, so I guess that's why it's very similar. Yeah, but it tastes good. It's not too heavy. I definitely recommend it.
C'est affreux là. Bah oui, c'est du sarcasme, oui, oui, oui. Bah oui, oui.
Et donc je suis rempli maintenant, je viens de sortir de restaurant. C'était sympa. C'était très bon. En fait.
Bah oui, oui, moi j'ai bien mangé aussi. Bon, c'était.
T'as passé une bonne journée avec moi, c'est ça?
Ouais. Bah oui, 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 évidemment, oui, bien sûr.
Le centre de Nice, sous la pluie. Et maintenant, on va aller à quoi? Messina Plaza Square?
Oui, on est à côté, oui, oui, oui.
Je prends le parasol avec moi.
C'est le pepperoni?
Oui.
Ça a l'air bon?
Pepperoni, c'est ça.
Oui, oui, je sais. Et j'ai pris aubergine. Et c'est ça, d'huile de piment, le poivron épicé.
Oui, c'est un peu épicé.
Donc on mange pizza crassée.
T'as pris quoi?
Citron. Citron vert et vanille.
Comme d'habitude.
Non, pas comme d'habitude.
Et moi aussi, comme d'habitude, j'ai pris chocolat macaron classique. Ça a l'air tellement bon.
C'est la glace à l'intérieur.
Oui, macaron à la glace et pistache, en petit. À la glace aussi.
Apparemment, c'est citron vert, basilic.
Oui.
Tu vois un peu les basiliques partout en fait.
Oui.
Ça sent bon ?
Ça sent bon, oui.
Tu peux sentir le basilic ?
Un petit peu, bah, plus tu sens le goût quand même.
D'accord. Mmh.